Hey guys, today we're looking at this AMD Radeon graphics card. It is the RX560D with 4 GB of video memory. We will find out what this card is all about, but let's take a closer look first. The RX560D we're using today is from Yesten. It was provided to our YouTube channel by Banggood, and you can find links down below in the description. Yesten is a Chinese brand, not that well known over here in Australia and other Western countries, but very established in China. In the box we have the graphics card, a quick information guide, and also a Molex to PCI Express power adapter. The card comes with DisplayPort 1.4, DVI-D and HDMI 2.0 connectors. Although the specifications state that the card requires less than 75 watts, it does require a 6-pin PCI Express power connector. There is a metal reinforcement strip at the top of the card, and for cooling there are 2 90mm fans. The cooling is what I believe to be the highlight of this card. After installing the drivers, I noticed that the fans stop turning. They are basically temperature controlled, and when you aren't playing a game, the fans will stop and the card will be perfectly silent. When gaming, the fans start spinning at around 58 degrees and do a very good job at cooling this card. After half an hour of stress testing, the temperatures stay comfortably in the 50s. So coming back to what is the RX560D, it was announced around July of 2017 and launched for the Asian markets. If we take a look at these specifications, we have a Polaris GPU with 896 stream processors running at 1.2 GHz. The 4 GB of GDDR5 run at an effective clock speed of 6000 MHz with a 128-bit memory interface. If these specifications sound familiar, well, they are. They match what we know as the RX460. So the RX560D is basically a rebranded RX460 aimed at the Asian market. Apparently, the RX560D is meant to be more efficient, but seeing that this card requires an external power connector, I do have my doubts. So let's take a look at the performance. Our test machine today has the i5-2400, 16 GB of RAM, and a solid-state drive. The graphics cards we're using today are the Yesten RX560D, we also have the Yesten GTX 1050, and the Gigabyte GT 1030. I have downloaded the latest drivers from the Nvidia and AMD website. So let's start by looking at 3D Mark. We have the two green lines here. These represent the GeForce cards. The bottom one is the GT 1030. The top one is the GTX 1050. And the red one is of course the Radeon RX560D. And you can see the exact result figures down below here. So in 3D Mark, the Radeon is pretty close to the GTX 1050. And here we have Crysis from 2007, all the games running at full HD. We've got all the detail settings here. I do that just to get a bit of more information out of the results. And we can see something interesting here. At the low details, the GeForce cards are stronger. This points towards the GeForce cards being a little bit more efficient with the processor, whereas the Radeon might need a slightly more powerful processor to get going. But that changes once we ramp up the details. We can see now the Radeon pulling in front of the GT 1030, but it's still behind the GTX 1050. In Dirt 3, we can see the Radeon basically being in between the two GeForce cards. At Ultra, however, it does fall behind a little bit and is closer to the GT 1030, which is surprising considering the Radeon does have 4 GB of video RAM, which is double what the other GeForce cards have. In Tomb Raider from 2013, we can see once again that the Radeon is a little bit behind at the lower detail levels, but once you crank it up, it gains ground and it is closer to the GTX 1050 than it is to the GT 1030. In Bioshock Infinite, a game from 2013, we can see once again that the Radeon sits nicely between the two GeForce cards. And here we got Rise of the Tomb Raider from 2015. Once again, we can see the card being a little bit weaker with the lower details, but once we crank it up, it gains ground, and at very high, it gets pretty close to the GTX 1050, very likely because of the higher amounts of video RAM. And a lot of you have asked for DirectX 12 results, so I ran Rise of the Tomb Raider with DirectX 11 and 12 for the Radeon. So the yellow graph is DirectX 12, The red one is DirectX 11, and I couldn't really measure much of a difference, just 1 FPS around here. So bottom line, in Rise of the Tomb Raider, DirectX 12 doesn't really gain you any extra performance. So looking at the performance, the RX 560D ends up between the GT 1030 and GTX 1050, closer in performance to the GTX 1050, but always a little bit behind. I had a quick go at overclocking, but didn't get very far, and after only a 10% overclock, we can see glitches and the driver crashing. I had no issues with the drivers and games I tried, and although I only got a standard monitor, the FreeSync support is well worth pointing out, basically a cheaper way to get into smooth, high refresh rate gaming. A quick word on pricing. You're looking at around $140 for the Yeston RX 560D from Banggood, but for the same price you can also get the Yeston GTX 1050. But with 4GB, the RX 560D does have double the amount of video memory, which will let you choose more detailed textures without getting any stutters. The RX 560D was up to now only available in Asia, but AMD has now also rebranded the RX 460 in other areas, causing a bit of confusion. So when shopping around for a RX 560, do pay attention to the specifications so you know exactly what you're buying. So to summarize, the Yeston RX 560D, we have what is basically the RX 460, but a nice version with 4GB of video memory, a metal reinforcement strip, and excellent cooling that turns the fans off and is silent when you aren't gaming. And that's it for this video. What do you think about this graphics card? If you found this video useful, please subscribe, click on the notification bell, like or dislike, and share it with your friends. Thank you for watching, and I shall see you soon with another one.